blistering agents, one of our five categories. These are also known as vesicants. Now, quick little tie-in back to the medical world. A vesicle is a raised lesion, basically a boo-boo, that appears on the skin. These things can be filled with clear fluids. So vesicants are going to cause blisters, thus the name blistering agent. Blistering agent causes painful blistering of the skin. These are not naturally occurring compounds. Quick little chemistry lesson for you. A compound is when you combine atoms together of different types. So for example, H2O is a compound. NaCl, sodium chloride, is a compound. Now, obviously, the chemical weapons are a lot more complicated than water and table salt, but you get the idea. The blistering agents can enter the body either by breathing it in, inhalation, or by contact with the skin or eyes. Some agents can even penetrate normal clothing material, which would allow blistering throughout the body. The entire body can receive the blistering agent and thus blister really badly. Typically, blistering agents work quickly upon the skin contact. They work quickly once they make contact with the skin, but the symptoms can be delayed. So what are the signs and symptoms of this? What does it look like if somebody has been affected? Well, we have the initial symptoms. These are the symptoms that are showing up initially at the beginning. And you're going to see reddening of the skin. This is going to kind of resemble a sunburn, pain in the affected areas, swollen skin, blistering, thus the name blistering agents, and lesions. Lesions is a $10 word for boo-boo, okay? So we have blistering and lesions. They may develop depending on how bad the exposure was. In extreme cases of exposure, we might have malaise, you might have vomiting, you might have fever, and even death is possible. No discussion of blistering agents can be complete without talking about the mustard agents. This is the most common of the blistering agents. In fact, every state, and when we're talking about states, we're not talking like in the United States where you have Texas and Florida and Virginia, we're talking about kind of nation states. So the US, Australia, England, France, Russia, we're looking at nation states here. So every state that has produced weapons like this have produced sulfur mustard. They have produced the mustard agents. Mustard agents are oily liquids that will range in color from very pale yellow to dark brown, depending on the type and purity that it has been made with. There's also a faint odor of mustard, onion, or garlic. These liquids will evaporate very quickly, and their vapors can also cause injury. The mustard agents first made their appearance during World War I. They were first developed in the late 1800s. Both sides of the conflict in World War I made these weapons as well as used these weapons against their enemy. If you remember from your history classes, you might remember something called trench warfare. There's your tie-in. Mustard-type blistering agents produced the greatest number of chemical casualties during World War I, but it's not as many as you would think. So even though this produced the most casualties, it only accounted for less than 5% of the casualties that died. Now, before you think that that's being cold-hearted, because any death in a war is horrible, when we're talking about these kind of agents, we have to start talking more analytically. We have to start talking about percentages and death rates and those things. So as far as chemical weapons go, this didn't cause a lot of death. This did not cause a lot of casualties. It made a big difference and it hurt a lot of people, but it only accounted for less than 5% of total casualties that died during World War I. In our next video, we're going to take a look at the very deadly nerve agents.